Latest approval ratings have shown support consistently plummet for the second in line for the throne since March 2015, only a third of those polled currently hold His Royal Highness in favorable regard, and just 22% support his claim to the throne following the Queen's death. Prince William, the third in line to the throne, remains the nation's top choice as the next instated monarch, winning the backing of 59% of those questioned. He also enjoys a general approval rating of 72%, making him the second most popular royal, after his brother, Prince Harry on 74%. Getty Prince William, left, enjoys far more support than Prince Charles, who is next in line to the throne. The proportion of people who advocate for William to be crowned as the next monarch has reached its highest point. James Endersby, managing director of Opinium Research. The Duchess of Cambridge has the backing of just under 2/3 of the public, but the poll shockingly revealed Prince Harry's girlfriend Meghan Markle has a lot of work to do. Approval ratings for the suit's star is the lowest among the royal figures, at just 19%. It is a slight rise from 16% she suffered just over 6 months earlier on April 24, 2017, polling firm Opinium Research, who surveyed 2,500 UK adults online between Tuesday and Thursday, also found the lowest level of support for the institution of British monarchy than at any point in the last 2 years. James Endersby, managing director of Opinium Research, told Express.co.uk that the Prince of Wales has consistently proven less popular with the public than Prince William. Mr. Endersby said the proportion of people who advocate for William to be crowned as the next monarch has reached its highest point since our monarchy tracker began. While the royal family are likely to conform to the traditional order of succession, it is likely they will continue to use the respective popularity of Prince William, Prince Harry and the Duchess of Cambridge to ensure the monarchy's overarching relevance with the UK public. Getty Prince Charles, pictured here with the Duchess of Cornwall, was named in the Paradise Papers leak. The lack of enthusiasm for the royal family may have been sparked by the anniversary of Princess Diana's death, which occurred 20 years ago in August. And the royals have faced a week of controversy over investments in overseas tax havens, after the Paradise Papers leak. The Prince of Wales was dragged into the row on Tuesday as it emerged that his estate has pumped millions of pounds into offshore companies. Critics accused Prince Charles of a conflict of interest over his Duchy of Cornwall investments in the Cayman Islands. BBC One's Panorama claimed the estate made about £100,000 after Charles campaigned for rule changes which would have benefited sustainable forestry management. SFM, it is not suggested that Charles had any personal knowledge of the investments or made any personal financial gains from them. Getty Prince Harry, pictured with girlfriend Meghan Markle, is the most popular member of the royal family. Among the most explosive claims is that the Queen's private estate has invested about £10 million in offshore arrangements. The Duchy of Lancaster, which provides the monarch with an independent income, reportedly held funds in the Cayman Islands and Bermuda between 2004 and 2005. A small amount was invested in rent-to-own retailer Brighthouse, which has been accused of irresponsible lending. The Duchy told the BBC that the holding now equated to £3,208. A spokesman for the estate said, "We operate a number of investments and a few of these are with overseas funds. All of our investments are fully audited and legitimate.